In the last lesson, we showed you the four main forces that come into flying a fixed-wing aircraft. I am going to jump back a bit and explain each one, and eventually I'll try and bring them all together. Okay, so a basic explanation of these forces can be this. Thrust is what increases the velocity of the aircraft. In takeoff, thrust brings you to the speed in which you achieve lift. In flight, thrust is used to overcome drag. Lift is used to overcome weight. Lift is the force that is created when air flows over the wing. At a higher speed of airflow, more lift is generated. Drag is the backward-acting force generated by resistance from the air as the aircraft moves through it, and also from what's known as lift-induced drag, which we will cover in more detail later on. Weight is the force generated by gravity that pulls the aircraft at an angle to the center of the Earth. Now, there is a state of flight where these forces are in harmony. The term is unaccelerated flight. That means that in straight and level flight that thrust equals drag and lift equals weight. All of the forces are in equilibrium. Doesn't that feel nice? So, when trying to achieve different states of flight like climb to a new altitude, these forces act upon each other in different ways. First off, the axes of rotation for an airplane are the vertical axis, or yaw, longitudinal axis, or roll, and the lateral axis, or pitch. These axes are a good thing to keep in mind when trying to understand what the airplane is doing and what its reaction will be. Let's give an example. Let's say you want to gain altitude, so you enter a climb. You pitch the airplane up on the lateral axis, and pitch causes some of these forces to change a little bit. When you change the angle of attack, meaning the angle of the wing to the relative wind direction, the entire airplane angle changes and creates more drag by adding more surface to the direct impact from the wind. The direction of the lifting force also changes. Because the wings don't move, the shape only gives force in one direction, and thus your lifting power changes. The loss in lift allows for weight to pull you down a little more. The other force, weight, is always pulling to the center of the Earth. So you changing the airplane's angle puts weight into a direction that works more directly against the force of thrust. I know what you're thinking, but nameless narrator, what do I do? Well, the way to keep your airspeed up and overcome the changes in the other forces is to add more thrust. Thrust needs to be increased to make up for the changing forces. Now, you only have so much thrust. At full throttle, if you increase the angle of pitch to a point where the weight and drag are too strong, you slow down too much, lose lift, and enter what's known as a running stall. The engine is running, but you lost lift on the wings, and thusly you fall. Now all of this is good information, but bear in mind that in each aircraft and on each flight, things react differently and change depending on your situation. A really good way to look at the whole of flight is momentum management. That's basically what you need to keep in mind. How much momentum do I have when you enter a climb, landing, descent, or any other maneuver? How much will that drag increase slow me down? Ask yourself these questions and act accordingly. The better you understand the forces involved, the better the decisions you can make.